Class 10th English. This is from Footprints Without Feet, your non-detailed textbook of English. The Thief Story, written by Ruskin Bond.
Good morning, students. I am Sudarshana Raj, your English teacher. We are going to study today a story from your non-detailed book. The name of the story is The Thief Story. It is by Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond is a famous writer who has portrayed the life of a thief through this simple story. There are two characters in this story. The name of the characters are Anil and Hari Singh. Hari Singh is a 15-year boy who is a thief. He is a meticulous thief, very talented. He always changes his name accordingly and he changes the name of the houses and the towns and the cities where he goes. He comes to Anil for a job. Anil basically is a very simple-hearted, generous, kind personality. So he offers a job for this young boy, Hari Singh. Hari Singh takes this opportunity to plan his theft from the house of Anil. Without knowing Hari Singh's true trait, Anil gives complete freedom to Hari Singh. One day, Hari Singh planned, he thought of stealing money from the house of Anil. He waits for that opportunity and one day he got such a kind of situation. He took the money from the mattress, under the mattress, and started thinking about going from the house. Actually, this Anil is a careless person who keeps everything, even if it's valuable, here and there, because he trusts Hari Singh. After taking the money, Hari Singh went from the house. But after moving a little, he thought of Anil, his master. The love and affection and the care and freedom which he got from Anil was incomparable. So he thought of his theft a lot. He definitely transformed his mind to a good one. And he thought cheating a trustworthy person is the most dangerous thing in the world. So he decided to go back to Anil's house. And he came in that midnight. It was raining too. But he decided to come back to Anil. He came to the house of Anil, kept the money from where he had taken and went to sleep. Next morning as usual, he prepared tea and gave to Anil. Actually, Anil knew that Hari Singh had taken the money, but without showing that, he decided to keep quiet. And he gave a 50 rupee note to Hari. Hari was actually ashamed. He became very guilty. And he thought of his bad deed in a very poor way. So, without knowing this, if Anil treats him lovely, it will be strange to us. But by knowing all these things, Anil decided to change him to a good person. So, from this story, we come to know about the value of honesty and trust. So even a bad man, even a thief can change his vile thoughts by taking example of a good man. You understood? So from this story, we will definitely study a very good lesson to make ourselves also refined from the bad habits which we have. Okay?
About the author. Ruskin Bond, born on 19 May 1934, is an Indian author of British descent. He lives with his adopted family in Landur, Mysore, India. The Indian Council for Child Education has recognized his role in the growth of children's literature in India. He was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award in 1992 for Our Trees Still Grow in Dehra, his novel in English. He was awarded the Padma Shri in 1999 and the Padma Bhushan in 2014. Overview. The story is about a 15-year-old thief who changes his name every month to stay ahead of police and old employers. This time, he kept his name Hari Singh. The other person in the story is a 25-year-old writer named Anil. The thief meets Anil and asks him if he can work for him. The story unfolds on how the thief betrays Anil by committing a theft but retracts later on. A young boy makes friends with Anil. Anil trusts him completely and employs him. Does the boy betray his trust? Let's look. Summary. The story is about two different people. One is a thief of 15 years of age and the other is a man of approximately 25 years watching a wrestling match somewhere. The name of the person watching the match is Anil. The thief approaches Anil and starts talking to him because he feels that he had not robbed anyone in the past few days and thought that it would be easy to rob a simple person like Anil. They both started talking and Anil asked the thief his name. The thief introduces himself as Hari Singh. This is not his real name as he changes his name every month to escape his ex-employers or police. Then they started talking about the wrestlers and Anil was leaving when Hari called him again and asked him if he could work for Anil. Anil said that he won't be able to pay him but could feed him if he knew how to cook. Hari lied that he knew how to cook. Anil took Hari to his room, which was above a sweet shop. Hari cooked a meal which was really bad because Anil did not eat it. Anil asked Hari to leave but he tried to please Anil. Hari smiled in his most attractive way and Anil could not stop laughing looking at him. Anil agreed to teach Hari how to cook, write full sentences and add numbers. Hari was grateful as he knew that there would be no limit to robbing people once he learned how to read and write. The narrator used to like working for Anil as he used to make him tea in the morning and then go out to buy the groceries for the day. He also used to steal 1 rupee from the money that was given to him to buy the groceries every day. Anil knew that he used to steal but did not mind. Anil used to make money by irregular works. Sometimes he used to borrow money and the other day when he had money, he would be lending it to other people. Whenever he used to get money, he would go out with his friends to celebrate. One day, Anil came in with a bundle of notes and told Hari that he had sold a book to a publisher. At night, he kept the money safely under the mattress of his bed. Hari realized that he had been working for Anil for more than a month and had not stolen anything apart from 1 rupee that he kept every day from the grocery money. Hari had many chances to steal as he had the key to the room as well. But he was surprised with the amount of trust Anil had on him as he had never seen such a trusting person in his life. This trust thing was preventing him from robbing Anil. As Hari thought that robbing a careless person like Anil didn't make much difference because he might not even notice that he had been robbed and that took out all the fun from the work. Then he thought of stealing Anil's money and justified himself that he didn't steal money from Anil. Then also he would waste it on his friends and also Anil did not pay him for the work that he did. Hari then woke up at night and quietly crawled to the Anil's bed. He steals the money and decides to leave the city by Lucknow Express that departed at 10:30. When he reached the station, the train had slowly started moving from the platform. He could have easily caught the train, but he hesitated that he himself did not know the reason for it. Before he had reached the station, he counted the money and it was 600 rupees in 50 rupee notes. He could live a lavish life for 2 to 3 weeks with so much money. After the train had left, Hari was all alone at the train station. He was left with no place to sleep at night. The only person he knew was Anil and he had looted him as well. He sat on a bench in park, and as it started to rain, he sat down under the clock tower. Then he realized that the notes had got wet. He realized that learning how to read and write would help him to get a much more respectable and honest job, which would pay him much more than these few hundred rupees. Then he decided to go back to Anil's house. He reached the room and placed the money back. Next morning, he woke up a bit late and Anil had already made his tea. Anil gave a 50 rupee note to Hari as he had got paid for some work and he would be paid regularly. Hari took the note in his hand and realized that the note was still wet from the rain last night. Hari realized that Anil had come to know about his misdeed, but there was no sadness, anger, or guilt in his mind. The narrator smiled in a beautiful way, and it was genuine happiness as he knew that he had saved himself from the wrong road. Now, let's discuss the question and answers related to this chapter. First question, what are Hari Singh's reaction to the prospect of receiving an education? Do they change over time? What makes him return to Anil? The question asks, what did Hari Singh understood or realized after getting educated? Do they change over time? And what made Hari Singh to return to Anil? The answer is, Hari Singh feels that education can make him earn a lot of money in an honest way. His prospect on receiving an education does not change over time. He feels that he can earn much more if he gets education. He returns to Anil because Anil trusts him, feeds him, treats him well, and even teaches him. Second question, who does I refer to this story? In the story, I refers to the thief who introduces himself as Hari Singh. Third question, why Anil doesn't hand the thief over to the police? Do you think most people would have done so? In what ways is Anil different from such employers? Let's discuss this particular question part by part. First, why Anil doesn't hand the thief over to the police? Answer, Anil did not hand over the thief to the police, maybe because he knew that Hari Singh had realized his mistake. He was feeling guilty for what he had done and wanted to mend his ways. This was the reason why he had come back and put the money back to its place. Anil wanted to give him a chance to become a better person. Because self-realization can place a person to its right path. Let's look the next part. Do you think most people would have done so? In what ways is Anil different from such employers? No. Most of the people will not do like this because I don't think that anybody in today's world would have done so, because to do so, a person needs to have a lot of patience and compassion, which is missing in most of the people today. In today's world, a thief is considered a criminal, even if he realizes his mistake. It takes a lot of courage to trust someone who has broken your trust once. Although I feel that if a person realizes his mistake, he must be given another chance to win back your trust. Let's discuss the next question. Fourth, Anil walked away. I followed casually. Why do you think the narrator followed Anil? The narrator's purpose of robbing Anil had not yet been served. He followed Anil to gain his trust and look for an opportunity that may help him to give shape to his plans. Question number 5. Was Hari successful in robbing Anil? Was Anil the only one who was robbed, or did Hari also rob himself of something? Answer. Yes, Hari Singh was successful in robbing Anil. But Anil was not the only one who was robbed at that time. Hari had robbed himself as well. He had lost the chance of receiving education and being literate. He had robbed Anil monetarily. But he had robbed himself of the chance for a better and brighter future, which was much more valuable. From this question, you must understand. In reality, people's attitude is that if we have money, we have everything. In that context, Harry was successful as he get money through stealing. But he had lost the chance of receiving education, and that's the point where Harry robbed himself. Question 6. What did Anil and Harry agree upon to the mode of payment? Answer. When Anil stated his inability to pay Harry, Anil questioned Harry if he could feed Harry. Harry realized that he had misjudged his target and molded the situation for his benefit. Anil then agreed to feed him if he knew how to cook. Question and answers. That means you have to think and write based on your story and build up your views about the story. Question number 8. Did Harry like working for Anil? Give reasons in support of your answer. Yes, Harry liked working for Anil. He was happy to carry on the course for him and was grateful for the education he was receiving. He used to make profit of about a rupee a day as well, which was decent amount besides being fed. Question number 9. How do you think Anil may come to know about the theft? Anil may have come to know about the theft because of the dampness of the notes because of rain. He was a kind but wise man. It wouldn't have been difficult for Anil to make out the series of events that would have taken place in the night. Question 10. Had Anil really forgiven Hari Singh? Support your answer with evidence. Answer. Yes. Anil had forgiven Hari Singh. It is evident because Anil handed over to Hari a 50 rupee note as soon as Hari woke up. Though he knew that Harry had robbed the money at first, but his subsequent actions gave him hope of change in Harry's character. Do you think people like Anil and Hari Singh are found only in fiction, or are there such people in real life? Let's discuss. We may meet millions of people in our life. The people around us are widely different from each other with respect to their characters. The character that I have is not the character that you have, isn't it? So in that way, we can say without any doubt, no. There are such people in real life also, although such people are rare in the today's society. The next part is, if one is caught stealing, people will first beat him severely. Then he will be handed over to the police. It should be realized that a human being is bound to commit error. One chance for reforming oneself must be given. This is only way to bring anyone to the right path. Punishing severely is not only the solution. Strictness can make them absolute criminal. 13th question. Money can't make a man as much as education can. Elucidate the statement. So we have already said in the previous slides that the attitude of human beings in today's world. If we have money, we have everything. I don't think this attitude is good. Education can take a man to more heights that the money alone can't. So children, you must keep this in mind. And now let's discuss the answer. The statement stands true in almost all the aspects of life. Money may buy us all the luxuries and fulfill our needs, but it cannot buy us knowledge, civilized thinking, skills, and abilities to achieve our dreams. Education lays the platform for all to act upon our goals according to our abilities. Education enables us to keep us with a fast-moving world. It opens the door to opportunities we do not know even exist. Money, on the other hand, can assist us to a certain level. It can buy us a plan, but education gives us the knowledge of its execution. Just as in the story, Thief's story, Hari Singh prioritized the chance of being literate over a few hundred rupees. We must understand that education can help us to achieve whatever we desire. Moreover, a better human being. Question number 14. Harrison then board the express and return to NL. Why did he return? On what values does this incident put light on? Answer. Harrison was a thief and he had stolen Anil's money. After the theft, he realized that he had robbed not only Anil but also himself of the chance of being literate and having a bright future. His conscience pricked him to think what he could have got if he knew the real value of education. It was difficult for him to rob Anil, but it was tougher for him not to be back. He realized that he could not make tea by daily supplies and learn how to read and write them. His inner self did not agree to bypass this and force him to return. Hari's return to Anil shows that despite indulging in criminal acts, he still had a practical and positive attitude towards life. It is awakening of Harry's conscience and Anil's love and care that reformed Harry's character. It teaches us that love alone can change a person. Anil's understanding nature and care changed Harry's thinking to mend his ways for good. This is all about the chapter. Children, please try to understand the summary of the chapter and also the question and answers that has been provided, as they are very important questions. And thank you for listening.